lovely bird. He's looking sideways. It's called What You Looking At. He looks like a little wise guy, but he's very colorful. And it was a relatively easy painting to create. I think everybody should be able to create this one. All you gotta do is sort of map out the shape, a log, and I'll show you how to put all those colors, wonderful colors and brush strokes in there. So stay tuned and I will show you how. Welcome back everybody. I'm Karen Zima, and today I'm going to be showing you, I felt like doing a bird, something more natural in nature. It's going to be looking that way, and it's going to be called What You Looking At. And it's going to be colorful, like on the chest, like yellows and oranges. This is like a leaf, he's hiding under a leaf. Maybe a little bit of traces of sky, like looking below up, and then he's sitting on a branch here. His paws hanging over, his claws. So, let us begin. And here are some of the colors that I chose for today. There's a bright yellow for his chest area, black and a white, two different shades of blue, some flesh color, purple, three different green shades, and we're just putting down the first layer of color to get it started. So I have this blue tone, it's dark, but it's a little too dark. So that's the first layer of color, and then we're gonna tone it down by putting in a lighter blue. Just tone it down. There we go, looks a lot better already. There we go, just be very loose. Down here. Just go down this body. First layer of color. And of course we're going to put feathers in. And I like the way the colors are coming off this brush like smaller brush and then to feather it in different layers of color. Let's get a little darker maybe at the top of his head. Thank you. chest will pop, like the yellows and the orange tones. So some of the chest colors I have is this orange, a lighter orange, a red, a yellow, maybe some purple and blues. So I'm going to start with maybe putting in the brightest part of the chest will be down here. Very lovely orange color. It is the first color that we are putting on. So some of this will be in there. Okay. Very pretty. Very pretty colors. And just kind of blend them in. Gonna let it dry a little bit while we put on this medium purple. Put a little black in it to make it more on the gray side. Start putting that in. I'm just trying to get the color in for now. Mm-hmm. Who wouldn't want to be a bird if you look like this? If you were this pretty. That's why I'm making them pretty. And then down, hanging out the bottom, down here, is going to be his tail. Down under here, it would be darker. Wouldn't be getting any of the light. So, just darkening that out. I do like the way the orange and the yellow kind of like float in there together. That's kind of what you want to look for, what you want to try and achieve. Things like that. Just another layer. We're going to put it on to dry. So I'm just going to start making, his chest is going to be lighter in the center. So I'm just making these feathery strokes. And I like the way the feathers would go. Get like a stiff brush to do this. Just keep blending them down. Now I'm doing these like twirly strokes to blend this top in. Done with the blending technique. Okay, I think we're going to put it in the branch so that we can see how we're doing here. So take a little bit of the red and mix it in with the purple tones. Come up with this pretty color here. Now lift that out. It's going to be like a pinkish tone branch because it looks good against green, whereas a brown would stand out like a sore thumb and it wouldn't look good. It wouldn't go with these colors. So. To my mom. She used to love her birds, and I think I'd make a great gift for any mom or dad that loves birds. Doesn't have to be a mom or dad, but if you are interested in this painting, you can contact me and I'll give you a price for it. And until next time, bye-bye.